happening in the world of pharmacy. And I want to say thank you so much for embracing the change. You know, when I look at how many more people are getting taking advantage of meds check, I just know that's people getting better care, that's people taking the right medication at the right time. I know it's people like my mom and my dad, both well into their 80s, and both on more medications than I could ever have, are getting the right combination, they're taking it the right way. I want to say thank you to the Pharmacists of Ontario for embracing the expanded role of MedCheck. I want to say thank you for embracing our narcotic strategy. You know, I remember so clearly, I think both Tina Perlman and Jim Sanchez are here. This is the first time I've realized they're both past presidents of the OPA. They came to my office to talk about some things. This is before I was Minister of Health. And we ended up talking about the real challenges facing pharmacists when it came to opioids. And they gave me some very, very good advice. And I want to say thank you to pharmacists right across this province for embracing the new narcotics database. I am so grateful that we have virtually all pharmacies now that are enrolled and actively participating in this database. You know, it's so the right thing to do, and I want to say thank you for embracing that. This is an issue that I have to tell you got a little bit personal for me, because I actually went on a ride along with a police officer in East London. There's wonderful things that he's talking about, maybe wrong, but there is some activity there, particularly sex trade industry, that I hope you all are staying away from. I ride along with a police officer whose job is to protect sex trade workers from being victims of violence. This is a world that was completely foreign to me. I knew nothing about that part of life. But when I met a woman who just a few months earlier had lived in the suburbs, she had a minivan, she had kids, she owned her own business, actually, and now she was turning tricks in order to pay for her addiction to OxyContin. I knew there was something that had to be done. And that, coupled with the wonderful, I think I see Jim in the dark there, Jim right here, he remembers very carefully, very clearly. He says, of course I remember, it was a week after my third armed robbery. He remembers. So we got to work, and I think we've come a long way since then. I want to thank you for your advice, Jim and Tina, and I want to say thank you to pharmacists for embracing this. You know, there is so much more to do. And Dennis is right, this is not a time to be protecting the status quo when it comes to healthcare in Ontario. I released the action plan in January. And the action plan responds to two very real issues. The demographic issue, which, as you all know, we're getting older. And an aging population puts different demands on the healthcare system, so we need to embrace that change from acute to chronic care. We need to embrace the reality that more of us are going to be on more medications. We also have a serious fiscal challenge. And I tell you, we cannot continue to borrow money at the rate that we have over the past couple of years. The recession hit Ontario very, very hard. We are determined to get back to balance within 5 years. And a big part of that is going to have to be borne on the shoulders of the healthcare system. Our government has made a very strategic decision. While some parts of our government spending is actually going to decrease, we're going to continue to spend more in healthcare. We're going to continue to spend more in education. But we have to be very strategic about how we spend that little bit more that we have. So the action plan talks about prevention as the first pillar of our healthcare system. So we've got to keep people healthier, and you are so much a part of that by helping people with chronic diseases manage those chronic diseases better. You're keeping people out of hospital. You know, one of the leading causes of readmission to hospitals is medication error. You are keeping people home where they want to be. You know, the second pillar of our action plan is a stronger role for primary care. We really have a vision where we see primary care as the doorway into the healthcare system. And pharmacists are playing a fantastic role in our family health teams and as full partners in primary care. But again, I think there's so much more that we can do, that pharmacists can do to be full members of our healthcare team. The third pillar of our action plan is the right care at the right time and the right place. So the right care is evidence-based care. The right time is early, whenever possible. And the right care is, again, evidence-based care from the right provider. I am so energized and so optimistic about the future of pharmacy. Our young pharmacists that are graduating now, how many students do we have here tonight? I want to say thank you for choosing pharmacy, and we are going to put you to work. You, I just am going to do a poll, though. I'm trying to figure out which is the better school of pharmacy. So you know that Bill 179 is working its way. Boy, does government work slowly, okay? We are on our way to implementing that Bill 179, and I'm delighted when I see how many of you are planning to be full participants in that expanded scope. But I have to say there's one thing that's been on my mind lately that is not included in one bill, in Bill 179. I've been looking at our immunization rates for the flu vaccine, and I am not at all happy, and I see that fewer than one third of Ontarians are actually getting the flu vaccine. Fewer than one in three of us are getting that protection. That means that there is an additional burden on our healthcare system. That means there are more people taking time off work. That means there are more kids losing time at school because they're not getting that vaccine. So I look at that and I think we can do better when it comes to our immunization. And then I look at other provinces and I see who's got higher immunization rates than Ontario. And I see provinces like British Columbia, who are now over half of the people in BC do get their immunization. Then I look at why do people not get their immunization. And I see that one of the biggest reasons they don't get it is it's just too hard. Easy enough for them to access that. And then I look at our pharmacies across this province, 3,000 pharmacies plus, and I think, I wonder if there's something we can do that will get our immunization rate where it ought to be. And that is much, much higher. So I don't have anything to announce today, but what I can tell you is that I think we can do better. I think more Ontarians can be protected. So I'm not sure if you agree with me or not. If we can prevent people from getting sick, you know, I have to tell you, I have to make some tough decisions in my job, you know that? But there are only two questions that I ask that really matter to me. And one is this better for patients? And is this better value for money? And if it's better for patients and it's better value for money, then the rest of us just have to figure out a way to make it happen. So I look forward to working with you. I very much look forward to working with you. We've got a lot of work behind us, but so much more work ahead of us. I want you to know that the OPA has been a wonderful, wonderful partner, and we will continue to work with the OPA to make sure that pharmacists are fully integrated members of our healthcare team. We're providing extraordinary care to Ontarians. I want to say thank you for that.